Jadron here. What is going on, guys? This is the GoPro Hero 4 on the Bugs 3 Pro with an AIO AKK all-in-one camera. This is the setup. Double-sided tape, camera there. Double-sided tape, battery there. Connect them. Done. This is my Wi-Fi setup. Or not my Wi-Fi, my FPV setup, excuse me, 5.8 gigahertz. As you can see, it says 5.8 gigahertz. I have an electrical tape just because the wire was a little bit loose, and now it seems to work a lot better. DR1 goggles that a cell phone slips into. That's it. All right, we're going to go for a flight. We're also going to record on the GoPro.
Here we go, guys. We have liftoff. So the bottom right corner is from the AIO all-in-one camera, the 200 milliwatt camera, and a really shaky image that has really, really clear, clear details is the GoPro. The mount underneath, I examined the mount underneath when I got home. You could see my all-in-one camera isn't shaking, so this drone doesn't give off a lot of vibrations. But back to what I was saying, I examined the mount when I got home, and the mount is meant to hold the stock camera. That's what they wanted you to use with this, but the GoPro fits in it perfectly with that little piece behind it that I used on the stock camera anyway. But it weighs more. It weighs more, and they didn't anticipate for you to throw a GoPro in it, otherwise you're gonna get shaky video like this. I think I have a way to remedy it, because again, look at the bottom right corner. There's no shaking, and there's no dampering or anything. That's just stuck right on top of the quad. So the shaking is actually coming from the fixed gimbal. It's definitely coming from the fixed gimbal, which we do need to remedy that, because I was actually hoping for epic GoPro footage. That's why I threw the GoPro on this, because I wanted to get really clean fly out. I knew I wasn't going to have pitch cutting out. I was going to have pitch. I didn't put a gimbal on this. A two-axis or three-axis gimbal. I didn't throw it on there, but I didn't care because I wanted the quality. You can see bottom right corner. I'm starting to fizzle a little bit on my all-in-one camera. I'm not sure why that is. I am over a mining area. There's lots of metals. There's lots of minerals. There's lots of stuff underneath this earth that could be affecting my signal, because I've gone out further. I've gone out much further than what we are right now with the 200 milliwatt camera. But since we're flaking out, we decide that we are going to turn around and come back home. And actually, that's about its limit. I wish I would have looked down so I could tell you its limit, although I did do a limit video. It is sitting there. I'm trying to gain control of it, and then eventually it does return home. And yet again, you can see bottom right corner, my AIO is having all types of interference over top of that mining field. As we get away from the mining field, bam, it's clear. It's clear. So I do definitely think there's some type of mineral deposit or metal or something that's underneath that earth that was messing with my, it was giving off interference, because I know this isn't a high interference area where I'm flying as far as gigahertz waves go. Now, over top of the little town over there, that I would deem a high gigahertz area, where you're probably having tons of 2.4 gigahertz, tons of dual band 5G bouncing around. Not so much 5.8 gigahertz, but just a lot of gigahertz floating around. Where I was flying, not so much, but again, I think might be a mineral deposit, might be magneticism of some sort under there that just kind of stopped us up. But we're flying. And again, coming back and not flying against wind, the jumpiness on the GoPro, which is the main screen, isn't as bad. It's just not great, though. The original Bugs 3 mount gave off a better image and better video than this one that has dampering balls on it. So I honestly think we just need to put a strap on it and tighten it up, keep it from moving around, and look at the clarity of the town. Really clear on the main image. Even on my all-in-one camera, it's not bad. That's why I like this AIO AKK camera. Link for this will be down below, absolutely, for the all-in-one camera. I'm going to put, I think it's 170 and change on Amazon. That's Prime. You can get it. You'll have it in 2 to 3 days. I'll put that link down below. Am I saying buy it from there? No, I'm not saying buy it from there. I'm saying buy it from there if you want this in a rush. I'm saying buy it from there if you want reassurance that you don't have to try to send us back to China if you want it cheaper, because I guarantee you can definitely probably find this cheaper on a Chinese site. And I'm not knocking anybody from doing that. I encourage you guys always do your homework. If I put a link down below and it's not the cheapest, guys, go do your homework and then weigh out the pros and cons. And again, the pros and cons that I'm weighing out here is buy it from Amazon, you have an issue, you send it back to Amazon, you get your money back, or you get another product. Versus buy it from China, get it considerably cheaper, you have an issue, and then you got to play a ping pong match with the guys over there, and you may or may not get your money back, or you may or may not get more product back, the same product. So definitely be aware of that. Be careful of that. You do have options. It's just like going to a retail store. If this Bugs 3 Pro was in the retail market, it'd probably be selling for $250 retail. Obviously online we could get it considerably cheaper because we kind of cut out all the shipping. We cut out the big box store. But again, China, you could get it even cheaper because it hasn't shipped out of the country. When you buy on Amazon, generally stuff is shipped out of the country. But here, look at the main screen. And I mean, as I'm talking, you should definitely be bouncing from main screen to bottom screen, checking it out. Right now, it's not bouncing too bad. It gets some bounces. What we're going to do, I decided I was going to do a altitude climb. Gonna do an altitude climb here, and I'm sad to report this is J Drone here. I'm reporting on the altitude status of the Bugs 3 Pro. The altitude status of the Bugs 3 Pro seems limited. It seems they've geofenced us at under 200 meters. Anybody else that has this drone, comment down below. Let me know if you've gone over 200 meters in altitude with this. I think I stuck at like 185 or something, which I wasn't happy about. Definitely wasn't happy about at all. I definitely would have liked to have climbed a bit higher, but in any juncture, I got a nice view. I definitely got a nice view, and you can see main image wobbling, bottom right not wobbling, bottom right there's no dampering. This is stuck right on top of the quad. Now main image, we have barely any wobbling, and then we get it back. So this just shows you, one, this drone can lift a GoPro. Two, you're gonna need to mod the gimbal if you want stabilized, like a stable, non-shaky image, almost, well, exactly like we have bottom right from the all-in-one camera that's literally just smacked right on top of it. There's a little good look. There's a good little look. There's a little good look of the little town via both of them, and you can see the perception. The GoPro has a more zoomed in perception as opposed to the AIO camera, which has a less zoomed in perception. But again, all-in-one camera, if you had to record just off of that, and I'm using OTG connection as I showed you in the beginning to a cell phone, it's definitely usable. It's definitely something that you can post and people will get the gist of where you're flying. Like right now, you can see a water hole above the second abyss. You can see the black area and the reddish kind of tannish area where they mine over there. You can definitely get a good clean picture off of this using a cell phone as a DVR. And obviously, it's not going to be as clear as your main image that we're seeing from the GoPro, but it's usable, and I've used it 100 times over. I have the Bugs 3 Mini fixed with the all-in-one camera, and I need to get that back out again. And we definitely need to fly that because it's actually fixed in there. Generally, I pop and play. I actually have it mounted in there pretty solidly where I don't want to pop and play. It's staying in there. And there's a little look at the second abyss, which is a much more aggressive abyss than that first abyss, which is up there where you can see the dark green tree line after the yellowish and green plane. And myself, I'm not standing where I normally do. Where I normally stand, and we're kind of panning over the mining area here. Once we go ahead and double back, I'll try to explain where I'm standing. Generally, I would be standing, see that water hole? Generally, I'd be standing almost right in front of there. See where these two roads kind of meet and then buckle around the abyss? Right where it buckles around the abyss is where I'm standing. We kind of started from a different point here just so I could get a different fly, offer you guys a little bit different perception from the drone. That way you're not seeing J Drone flying the same area in the same place and just doing a straight run out and yeah, J Drone, same boring run. No, I'm switching it up a little bit. So hopefully you guys appreciate that. We definitely have definitely have a lot of people that keep chiming in on these videos. James Buck, he's been in there. TYWITTE. Steve B has been hitting out with first comment. And Ray, my man Ray's back on point again. He's been getting close to the first comment. I think he might even had one today. But he's been hitting it second. And again, there's no contest. I mean, there obviously you guys can have a contest among yourselves, try to figure out who's getting a notification bell quicker, or who's on point with J Drone's channel and smacking that like button first and commenting first. By all means, compete up. Like I said before, like I said yesterday, I'm happy to have anybody watching. If you don't want to comment during these videos, if you don't want to say a word, I still appreciate you. You're silent. I'm not so silent about it. I appreciate you, even though you're not commenting. I appreciate every single person that tunes into the J Drone channel. I'm tripping over my words here a little bit. It's 9 minutes past midnight here, and I'm doing this recording. By the time you guys see this, it'll probably be like 1:30 or something. It takes a little while to save some layers, but J Drone's a little bit tired. I went on an urban explorer adventure by a bike, and it was probably 2 3 mile out and 2 3 mile in, and I haven't been on my bike in a little while, so I'm not super super conditioned the way that I should be. But we are getting close to downtime here, where we are going to shut this down. If you haven't subscribed, please do.